If we can imagine ourselves in Jesus, with Jesus in his public ministry, if we can imagine ourselves being one of his disciples and talking through the mission that Jesus has for the world, we could talk through all the possible options of how to ensure that the world will know that it has been saved, that it's been redeemed, that it's been rescued by Jesus. We could create a list of things that we might say, talking points that we could use to convince the world that its Savior has come to reconcile us with God. And we would say, well, he healed people, he preached with authority, he raised a man from the dead. And then after the resurrection, we would update our list and we would say, well, he suffered for us and he died, and then he came back from the dead. I think these are the things that we would emphasize to show that Jesus is really the Savior of the world. And I suspect that telling the world that we should eat God, who becomes present in a tiny wafer of bread, would not be at the top of a list of things that we would use to convince the world of Jesus' presence, because it sounds preposterous. We can almost hear Peter saying, let's not lead with that one. Maybe let's hold that one back until later, until people are on board with what we're talking about. And yet, it is the thing that defines us as Catholics. It is the hallmark of our sacramental life that feeds everything else that we do. Without the Eucharist, without Christ really present to us, we would only be holding on to rituals of the past that have long since lost their meaning. If Christ is not here in this sacrament, if he doesn't become present in the form of bread and wine, then we are fools for doing this. Because a symbol can never replace a person. You know, if a child is screaming for its mother and needs to be fed, you can't put a cardboard cutout of a mother in front of that child and expect things to get better. That child needs a presence, a person who can feed them. We can't put robots in front of our children in school and expect them to have an experience of being loved and cared for. And we can't put a piece of bread that represents Jesus or reminds people of Jesus in front of a congregation and expect them to be changed by it. A symbol can't replace a person. The presence of a person. You and I don't need a God who is watching over us from above, from some distant place far off. You and I need a God who joins us in life, with all of its joy, with all of its sadness, all of its tragedy, which we see in the world today. We need a presence, a real presence, who enters in to us to change us and to purify us and to give us new hope. This is the heart of the church. The one who is here and who gives himself to us in this Eucharist is the heart of the church. A Eucharistic miracle in Poland in 2008, a Eucharistic miracle in Venezuela in 1991, a Eucharistic miracle in Mexico in 2006, Eucharistic miracles in Argentina in 92, 94, and 96 all have one thing in common. The host began to bleed, and when the blood was tested, and in Venezuela it was tested by 500 commissions from the World Health Organization, the blood came back AB positive in every case, and it came from the tissue found in the heart of a man. But it wasn't blood from a dead heart. It was blood from a living heart, a beating heart. Because the heart of Jesus still beats for us. The heart of Jesus still pushes life into the church and through us in this Eucharist. Science is just verifying what we already know to be true theologically. That this is not some dead ritual that the church tells us that we have to go to in order to avoid falling into mortal sin. This is an encounter with Christ on the cross as his heart was pierced with a lance and whose blood pours out over us and over the entire church so that his life could be in us. We're not sprinkling blood on people like Moses did in the Old Testament. That blood is entering through us to give us life, not any life, but the divine life of God. It was the completion of what Jesus began at the Last Supper as he changed the bread and wine into his body and blood. Friends, Christ is here. Jesus is here. He's here for you and for me to look us in the eyes, to remind us of how desperately he wants to stay with us in every circumstance. God does this for us. You remember when Jesus was crucified, and after the crucifixion, the veil in the temple was torn, and it was torn not from bottom to top with human hands, but from top to bottom from the divine hands of God. God pulled open the veil between divinity and humanity. Jesus brought us together. And here in this Eucharist, God again tears the veil that exists between time and space so that we can stand there in front of the crucifixion and recognize that the Lord is there saying to us, this is what I'm doing for you right now. And we can watch it. This is everything that I have poured out for you. Every drop of blood in my body I give to you so that you will know that you are loved. And Jesus covers himself in the form of bread and wine for our sake, so that we can eat and drink of him and frankly not be grossed out by eating real human flesh and drinking human blood. Jesus wants us to receive him, not in some mental way, not in some spiritual way, but physically he wants us to receive him. And that's why a symbol cannot replace a person. Because to sacrifice a symbol is nothing. It's replaced by another symbol. But to sacrifice oneself is everything. It's the total gift for the sake of someone that you love. And this is what the Eucharist is. It is the greatest act of love ever offered in this world. Because God, the maker of everything, has humbled himself for the sake of offering himself so that we would know that we are never alone. And you know, the amazing thing, God isn't asking to be repaid because he knows that we can never repay this gift. He's just asking to be received. This is what Jesus wants for us. This is what God wants in return for this gift, is that we would receive him with grateful hearts. May we know his love today in this sacrament as he gives everything, every last drop of blood, to remind us that he has saved us and has brought us back into union with his Father.